Shoulder pain and shoulder problems is one of the most common joint injuries, as the shoulder is such a mobile and complex joint. So I'm going to show you three things that you can do to stretch them out, to test which side is your tight side, and to see the range of motion that you've got. Because more than likely, if you've got shoulder pain, your range of motion in that joint is very limited. And we're going to test that, and I'm going to show you how to fix that. So there's three stretches that you can do to test your range of motion. And more than likely, the side that's affected is going to have a way less range of motion because those muscles are pulling tight. You could have pain in the front or the back or deep inside in the subscapularis, which is underneath the shoulder blade. And it's very hard to pinpoint sometimes. So I'm going to show you these three stretches to check your range of motion, and then we're going to go and stretch them out. First thing you want to try is straight arm and lifting it straight up and seeing if you can get a full range of motion, getting your arm all the way up to the sky and keeping your arm as close to your ear as possible. You don't want to be going out far here. You want to feel that stretch as close to your head as possible. Check both sides. Limited range of motion, you'll feel that one side doesn't go as high. It might only go to here. You might not get it all the way up. So you can see how far each arm goes up, and the affected side probably be a little bit less range of motion. The second stretch we're going to try is going from the side and going as high up as we can. We want a full range of motion. Check the right side, and we want to get as close to our ear as possible, keeping our arm straight, just to check that range of motion, to make sure that we've got a full range of motion. Last stretch we're going to do is going behind your back and reaching and seeing how high up your arm can go. So you're going to reach behind, feel how high you can go on the one side, and we're going to do the next side. Now my left side is definitely tighter. I can't go as high. If I do it on my right hand side, it goes quite high and it's quite easy. My left side, I have to force it up and it feels quite tight. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a resistance band. We're going to do three simple stretches, loosen it up. Okay, so what I've got here is this resistance band that is pretty strong. And what you can do with this resistance band is loop it around something sturdy and we can stretch with it. Okay, so I've tied it with a loop onto something that's not going to just fall over, so we can give it a nice stretch and it's not going to topple over. You can do it in a door frame if you've got a little bar or something that you can put it on. Tie it quite high because we're going to be pulling a little bit up and away from our body, so get it high up and then we can do the stretches. Okay, the first stretch we're going to do is stretching it straight up and getting the range of motion straight up. So what we're going to do is put our arms straight through the band. We're going to step forward, getting that arm way up, and you want to take another step forward and get that arm a little bit back. Now if you feel too much pain, don't go too far forward. Try keep it as close to your ear as possible. Keep your arm straight and just go to a point where it feels like it's stretching. You don't want to be hurting yourself. You can work your way up and progress. You can just stretch slowly and get it up there. You never want to push past what you can do, because you can injure yourself. That's with any injury, thoracic outlet syndrome, frozen shoulder, or if you've got rotator cuff injuries, you don't want to push past that point of pain, because sometimes it really ends up in injury. You just want to help your body get that extra length, get those muscles strengthened and loosened a little bit, and eventually you'll get stronger and more supple so that you can go further back. Okay, the next stretch we're going to do, we're going to put our arm straight into the loop like this, and we're going to keep our arm straight, put it behind you. Keep a straight chest. You don't want to be leaning forward. You want to keep a straight chest and take a step back. What we're doing is just getting this arm away from our bodies, getting that stretch in our shoulder and getting that tightness to loosen up. So you want to get this arm pretty high, take a step back again, get this arm pretty high up and away from your body and just hold that stretch. Make sure that it's behind you so that you're really feeling it in the front of your shoulder and getting those muscles nice and loose. Again, you don't want to push too hard, just go to where you can. If it's too hard, don't lift your arm too much. Remember, when you're in this position, to keep your chest up so that it will work the shoulder properly and isolate it. Okay, then the last stretch we're going to do is very similar to the second one. We're going to loop our arm in the band again and put it right behind us like we're going up in that same stretch. And with it behind us, we're going to do the same thing, chest up. You're going to step forward and get a nice stretch in the front of your shoulder.
what you want to do is get your elbow away from your body. So you really want to get that stretch up and get your elbow away. Remember to keep your chest up, straight back, and just step forward slowly, getting it further and further away until you feel that stretch. So these three stretches are really going to help loosen your shoulder. You're going to get more range of motion. You're not going to have that tightness. When you go back into checking your range of motion, you'll feel that you can go a little bit higher, you can reach further up, and you'll have a lot less of that tightness deep inside the muscles. So just keep doing this on a daily basis. Do it every second day, maybe, if you're a little bit too tight the one day. And slowly over time, you're going to feel a lot less pressure in your shoulder. Those muscles are going to loosen up and you're going to feel more relaxed in your shoulder. You're not going to have that tightness and that pressure and that very deep pain deep inside the shoulder. It will also strengthen your shoulder, because having it more loose when you're training and actually can lift things, your muscle is training in the correct way. It's relaxed. You're not training on a tight muscle, which can cause instability. So give these a try. Let me know in the comments down below if it helps you, or if you have any other questions of any other injury, let me know, and I'll see you guys soon.